we did our own navigation on the way back from the moon. We wanted to prove to the world, I guess, that if we were going to Mars and we lost all radio contact, that we could still get back home. Interesting, back in those days, we had a small computer, but that computer only had 75K of memory. I mean, this watch that I'm wearing has more than that. Because of the small memory we had to get rid of some computer program. And the one they got rid of on our flight that I really objected to was a program called Return to Earth. So we had no way of getting back to Earth if we lost all radio communication. So we did our own navigation on the way home. And what was interesting about it is to place us in the Earth-Moon system, I did a sextant sighting on a star and on the Earth horizon. But what we realized very quickly was that from a couple hundred thousand miles away, if you're looking back at the Earth and you're trying to get a data point on the Earth's atmosphere, there's too much distance in that. The atmosphere is about 50 miles thick, and if you make a 50-mile error coming back, you got a big problem. So what we had to do was find a color line in the horizon. If you blow up the horizon, you look at that whole 50 miles, it goes from white at the Earth and all the way up to black in the sky, and it goes through all the colors that there are. And I picked the blue color because that was the one. It was a very thin color, but it was very bright, and it was one I could see all the time. And we used that to do our star sightings and to fix our position in the Earth-Moon system. And we did all of our own calculations on the way back home from the moon. And we actually ended up at almost exactly the same spot that Mission Control would have had us on the ocean when we came back. So we proved the point that you can actually navigate, at least in the Earth-Moon system, using onboard equipment as opposed to getting everything from Mission Control.